Hey everyone, so today I am talking about kids and nearsightedness. So if you want to learn how to slow down your child's glasses prescription, then stay tuned. This is a common question I get a lot in my office from parents that are concerned about how every year when they come into the eye doctor's office, their kid's glasses prescription just gets worse and worse and worse. And before, I wouldn't really be able to tell them very much. They would ask about exercises and food and vision training, and none of that has really been proven to be helpful at slowing down nearsightedness or myopia. But in the last few years, a new drop has come out that helps with slowing that down. So I'm going to be talking today about low-dose atropine. There are some other ways to slow it down too that are coming out in the research, and that'll be in a separate video. But for now, we're talking low-dose atropine. So first, why is it important to slow down your child's nearsightedness? It's not just about how thick the glasses are. What really makes a difference is for kids that are nearsighted, their eyeball tends to be longer than kids that are not nearsighted. This also holds true for adults. So, what am I talking about? Let's look at my trusty little eye model here. So this is how long the eyeball is from front to back. That is called the axial length. And in individuals that are nearsighted, your eyeball is stretched a little bit longer. It's why you're nearsighted. It's why the light focuses here instead of back on the retina, because your eyeball's long. So why is axial myopia dangerous? Why do we even care how long your eyeball is? So what? Well, think about it like this balloon that I snagged for my children as your eyeball. Okay, think of this as your standard person's eyeball who's not nearsighted. This is their retina inside. Standard length and circumference. Now, what happens if the balloon or eyeball is longer? You see more of the light blue. It's the material, the balloon is getting stretched a little more thinly. And that's basically exactly what happens for the retina in nearsighted individuals. The retina of the eye gets stretched more thinly as the eye elongates. So that's why we're trying to prevent kids who are nearsighted from developing this elongation of their eyeball. It'll help hopefully prevent retinal tears and detachments. And retinal tears and detachments lead to blindness. Not always, sometimes they can be caught early, but they can lead to blindness. So if we can find this preventable way of decreasing that chance, that's what we want to do. So what is low-dose atropine? Low-dose atropine is a drop, and atropine has been around for like 30 years in this country. It is an FDA-approved medicine. It's actually a dilating drop. It makes your pupil large, and it makes it so you can't see for about a week. Pediatric ophthalmologists use atropine 1%, the regular strength available in the pharmacy, for treatment of a lazy eye. But what these doctors did in Singapore, these ophthalmologists, what they did was they started to dilute the drop, and then they gave it to children every day for 2 years. So they gave it to kids ages 5 to 12 every night, and to see if it helped with their nearsightedness. And not only that, like how high their prescription was, not just did they go from a -2 to a -2.5, but really, does it help with this thing, with decreasing the axial length? Because again, that's what's most important from a health standpoint. And when they looked at it, they diluted it down to 1/100, so 0.01%. They did all different dosages, 0.05%. So remember, these are tiny dosages compared to 1%. And they found that it actually does help slow down that progression. Now remember, with nearsightedness, it is gonna get worse and worse and worse no matter what. But what we're trying to do is make that more of a, like, you know, less steep of a slope so that we can slow it down. And in some kids, it actually stabilized it completely or even made it just a hair better. Atropine drop, where do you get it? When you get the regular strength atropine 1%, you can get that at your local CVS or Walgreens or Walmart or Target. That's available at the pharmacy. This drop, which they're diluting, is not available at those pharmacies. It has to be mixed by a special compounding pharmacy. A compounding pharmacy will make all their drugs and their medications. So they actually sit with a pipette and dilute it down 1/100th and put it in a bottle for you. That also means that usually there's no preservatives, so one bottle only lasts a month and you've got to toss it, okay? The second thing to note is that even though atropine 1% is an FDA-approved medicine, it's FDA-approved for dilating the pupil. When we dilute it down, it then doesn't have the FDA approval. It's not approved for stabilizing nearsightedness. So that's what's considered an off-label use of this medication. So I have all of my patients have to sign a consent so that they understand, or the parents, sign the consent saying that they understand that this is considered an off-label use of the medication. Therefore, sometimes insurance does not cover the medication, and sometimes it doesn't cover the testing, because here's the protocol. I will start a patient on the drop, atropine drop, and at that time, we do a glasses check and we figure out what their prescription is. And then I also do what's called an axial length measurement. So I measure how long is their eyeball, 22 millimeters, 23 millimeters, 24 millimeters. Some kids have really long levels, 25, 26 millimeters. We get that as a baseline. I then see patients for free 1 month after just to make sure they're not having any side effects. Side effects that would include difficulty reading. That was not reported in any of the studies, but that's a possibility. Side effects would also include light sensitivity or irritation, just kind of stinging or burning in the eye. So those are the main ones. And that's what I'm looking for when I see the patient at 1 month. It's a quick visit in and out just to make sure that their pupil size is not getting too big from the dilute version of the drop and that they're not having side effects. Then we see them every 6 months, and every 6 months we check the prescription. And sometimes that's not covered by insurance. We also check the length of the eyeball, and usually that's almost never covered by insurance. And we do that same protocol every 6 months for 2 years. At the end of the 2 year, we take them off of the drop, and then we check them one more time at 6 months after that, just to make sure that there's no backsliding, that they haven't gotten worse, way worse, or their eyeballs haven't gotten really long. It's kind of like a rebound. And if everything is great, then you're good, you're done. Finish. But if it seems to be getting worse again, then we'll start treatment again for a year. So that's low dose atropine. It's such a great tool to have in my toolbox as a pediatric ophthalmologist to be able to help pediatric patients. I don't have any financial interest in the drop. Like I said, it's manufactured at different compounding pharmacies. But it is something that I really believe in, because that's basically the crux of it. There actually is something you can do for nearsightedness and to slow your child's nearsightedness down. And I think that's the goal of every parent, if you can do that, even if there is an out-of-pocket expense. So I hope that answers people's questions. But definitely, if you found this video helpful and you want to see more content like this, please subscribe. Mahalo.